Hello. Hi. I had a request for a video in English, so here I am. Hi, I'm Marie Minkonen from CreaLife. I'm a visual artist and I make these videos every now and then to kind of let you in to my studio and my painting process. And the painting behind me is the one I showed in the last video. It's still not finished, but it's getting there. And this morning I had the guidance or the impulse to start a new one and do this one in English. So welcome. And not the focus of this video, so I'm just gonna say hi and then turn the video down to my canvas and start. And I'll speak a little bit about what's been on my heart lately. Both what's come up inside of me, what I've been aware of in the world, and what clients have brought to me on a general level. And here goes. Welcome. If you want, I invite you to take your own pen or dance or whatever creative thing, writing or cooking or doing the accounting, whatever, and join me, because these videos are really, really long, basically just painting and talking, and they're a good backdrop for whatever it is you're creating in your own life. Okay, I'll turn the camera now. And then we'll see what happens next. Let's see. That was not very graceful, but okay. So let's start. Okay, I forgot my water bottle. I like to make underpaintings that flow. Intuitive way to kind of let the colors and shapes find me. And let's see what we have on the agenda today. Trust. That is what's been up for me lately. So I picked a divine name a couple of years ago. I studied at Heart of Business with Mark Silver and Steve Mattis and others, and I learned a whole lot about a process called remembrance, and that has become a core part of my day. It's a way to connect with my heart and with the heart of the universe, if you will. And these concepts are just words to try to describe what it is that I'm really meaning. And today I picked one of the 99 divine names of Allah. It was Al-Adl, which is, among many, many, many other things, and now only in my understanding, great equalizing force. I've always been really interested in paradox. This life is such a weird journey that I really feel
are holding completely contradictory phenomena inside. And what's been up lately has been this combination of trust and awareness. Trusting intuition, trusting the guidance that I feel coming through me. Trusting doing the next risky move and the next risky move. Trusting also the moments when I feel like doing nothing, when there's just no next step except resting and leaning into the present moment. And so that's a kind of surrender, that's a kind of listening and surrendering to what comes through me and not trying to control that. It takes a lot of trust. Trust that doesn't always come so easy. Right? And then, for me, I don't know if this is a true paradox. I'm not smart enough to know yet. But hand in hand with this trust and surrender has been a real strong need and determination to use my intellect to check in. Is this, how did that work? How did that trusting, that throwing myself into the moment, that following guidance as I understand it, how did it work? What were the results? And not only in my mind, but in the minds of others and hearts of others. What was their experience? What was my impact on them? You know, to not assume that my perspective is the only one, or that what I offer lands in the way that I need it to offer. That I mean for it to come through, you know? Because I can't. We can never be sure of that unless we ask and verify, how was this for you? You know? And so hand in hand with trust and surrender has been deep process of accepting my mistakes, of accepting the consequences of following guidance, and somehow for me this is such a big and important part of my journey, spiritual journey, if you will, to learn, how would I say this? To learn that although I have an active part in this life to participate, my action is important. Our actions are important. Our will is important. Our effort is important. Still, you know, with all the dreaming, goals and visions, all that, we still don't control anything. Anything. It's not up to us. We can do our best, we can participate, we can trust. And then we have to let it go. I guess somewhat of a paradox to me, that I can follow my intuition, I can follow the guidance that I'm able to be aware of right now. And things can still turn to shit. Completely. They don't necessarily do, but they can. Sometimes they do. And then I learn from that. And I think that's where remorse comes in. I'm grown, as so many of us are, with a lot of guilt and a lot of shame. So I used to be really afraid of apologizing, of admitting that I've done something wrong, until I found and learned about remorse. Wow, did you see that? There was cerulean and blue just jumping out on the canvas. Remorse is an extraordinarily gentle and soft and healing feeling, as I've come to understand it in the past. Remorse is an understanding that my actions have hurt somebody else. They have brought discomfort and something different than I intended to the person I'm in relationship with. And the remorse is feeling a deep sense of compassion for the suffering of the other person, a deep curiosity in their experience, and a deep acceptance of my own role in that experience. What I did had an impact on you, and I feel really sorry for that impact, regardless of what my intent was. Yeah. Okay, so this was a fast one. Yeah, the canvas isn't very big if you look at it. I don't remember what it was, maybe 109 centimeters this way? Something like that. I'm getting the distinct sense that this underpainting is done and needs to dry. I'm sitting here wondering, I'm asking the canvas, because this is how I do it. I'm asking the canvas, is there anything more that you need from me right now? Can I do something? And I'm not getting anything. So this is probably it. And I'm just making a note of, I've used ultramarine blue. I've used dire light.
wishing you a good day. I will post follow-up pictures in the thread of this video, so you see what this painting turns into, and I will put in a prize if you're interested in purchasing it. And yeah, we'll see what happens.